In this short video, I'm going to show you how to create a new page in Physiopedia. But before I do anything else, I'm going to check that there are no other pages on the topic that I'd like to create already existing within the site. It's really important that we don't duplicate pages because that's additional information that could all be put into one place. So what I would do is do a search for the topic that I'm going to thinking of creating. Now I'm thinking of creating a new page on sleep. So I use the search box at the top navigation bar here and put in the word sleep. The search results will show me everything related to sleep, and I can see that there is a couple of pages on sleep apnea at the top, but nothing just describing sleep. So for that, I can see that it's probably worth having a page on sleep. What I will then do is create a new page. Now I can never actually remember where to go to do this, so I actually use the search box again. This time I type in create, and at the top there it gives me the creating a new page. So I'll go to this page. Now I've already done the search to check that there is no existing page on this topic. So what I then do is choose a title for the page and type it into this grey box. And I click on create new page. What that simply does is gives me this editing box, which is actually the source code of Physiopedia. So it shows me the wiki text, which is the source code. What I need to do is just type something in this page. So what I will normally do is do a template. So I'll use the new page template first of all in this page to give me some structure to the page. Now what I simply need to do is type in this, two curly brackets, S-U-B-S-T, colon, new page, close the curly brackets. That's how you put a template into a page, and I just happen to know that that is how we put in the standard template for a new page. So it's worth remembering that and using that in the future, because then when you save the page, your new page, it will just give you a template existing within the page already so that you can start working underneath those existing headings and the references are already added and things like that. As well, the editors will already be added because that comes within the template as well. So that is how you create a new page.